Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the lead editorial on civil society. Now the civil society editorial, it has relevance to sociology, it has relevance to public administration, it has relevance to political science, and it is also relevant to GS paper 2 and GS paper 4. Now this editorial is written by Neera Chandok. This editorial, though it relates to civil society, but in order to have a better understanding about this editorial, we need to understand democracy. Now when we understand a democracy, it is a way of a system whereby people elect their representative, where people actually assert what they really want. Democracy is a system whereby we accord a lot of prime role to the people. We accord them a role that is very pristine and that is very sacramental. But when it comes to democracy, democracy is not a kind of a uniform system. There are different variants of democracy, and we really need to understand those subsets of democracy. Democracy is having a kind of its own spectrum. Democracy can be understood in a better manner if we will be understanding it from the perspective of the spectrum. On the one end of the spectrum, we have the participative democracy. This is a kind of a democracy in which the people really assert themselves. So this is very, very important. People really assert themselves. There is a high element of accountability and control. This is the most important thing about the participative democracy. Now, another important thing about the participative democracy is that the politicians, they are not able to assert themselves when it comes to the policies, when it comes to the programs, when it comes to coming out with the new laws, when it relates to coming out with new enactments. The people assert themselves and they believe that there should be proper dialogue, there should be proper discussion, there should be proper debate, there should be proper critical analysis of the policies. So this is the importance of participative democracy. Now such kind of democracy involves the active role of the civil society. It is the civil society which really criticizes the government policies. It asks the government to choose some other alternative that the civil society is coming out with. So civil society is nothing. It is a mechanism by which the people really participate on a real-time basis. Now, this is very important. Real-time basis. Continuous. Now continuity is very, very important when it comes to making democracy accountable. Now on the other end of the spectrum, we have a democratic system which is not participative. Then what it is only representative. People really don't participate in the policy matters. People really don't assert themselves. People really don't try to generate accountability and control from the government. People only want that they should be only electing their leaders, that is their parliamentarians. So this is the only purpose served by the people in the representative democracy. There is no real-time accountability. There is no dialogue thing. Now, there is actually a tyranny of the legislature. Now, whatever policy the legislature want in this type of system, representative democracy, now that kind of policies will be enacted by the parliamentarians. The voices of the people are rarely heard in representative democracy. People's role is only confined to the elections. But when it comes to the participative democracy, it is a very engrossive system of democracy. अगर देखा जाए तो पार्टिसिपेटिव डेमोक्रेसी रियल डेमोक्रेसी है, ये एक सब्सटेंटिव डेमोक्रेसी है जिससे कुछ ना कुछ रिजल्ट्स जनरेट होते हैं. सो दिस इज द एसेंस ऑफ पार्टिसिपेटिव डेमोक्रेसी. नाउ व्हेन इट कम्स टू इंडिया, नाउ इन इंडिया इट विल एज पर नीरा चंडोक टिल 1970s वी वर हैविंग अ सिचुएशन वेयर बाय द सिविल सोसाइटी वाज नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड. Now, understanding of the meaning of organized is very important. Means that the people collectively were not having their viewpoint about democracy. People collectively were not having a viewpoint that they should be asserting themselves. There were less of social audit done by the people. But after 1970s, ending of 1970s, we witnessed after the emergency phase that the country had witnessed, country had undergone a metamorphosis. Metamorphosis in terms of organizing civil society. Now this is very important. Now we have a civil society that is really organized. But why this editorial has been written? Now this editorial has been written by Neera Chandok in order to caution the government that the government should not be trampling. Government should not be. Now this is the word that has been used. Squeezing. Should not be squeezing the space of the parliamentarians. Because if they will be squeezing the space of the parliamentarians, sorry, of the people, in that case, the democracy, Indian democracy will be moving towards the representative democracy only. And it will not be moving towards the participative democracy. Now this end of the spectrum of the democracy is the real democracy. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you have any sort of query. Now in order, if you want to place orders about the video classes that we are offering, you can visit BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.